Hi dear students, now we are going to continue with the poem Our Casuarina Tree written by Toru Dutt. Last week we learned the first two stanzas of the poem. In the first two stanzas, the poetess explains the strength or magnificence of the casuarina tree. In the remaining stanzas, we are going to learn the remaining stanzas today. In the third and fourth stanzas, there is a mood change. The poetess explains how dear or how close the casuarina tree to her soul. The casuarina tree is very close to her soul, not because of the magnificence or huge appearance of the tree, but she says that the casuarina tree is very close to her heart because of the nostalgic memories of her childhood days, where she played under the casuarina tree with her brother Abju and her sister Aru. Both her brother and sister died very young. Even though years pass, her love towards her siblings, brother and sister, is so deep or so intense. Because of her love towards her sister and brother, the casuarina tree also is very dear to her soul. She hears a dirge-like sound. A dirge-like sound is the lament of the tree. The casuarina tree also cries over the loss of her brother and her sister. She imagines that it is a strange communication of the tree. The tree tries to communicate with her siblings and also with Toru Dutt, even though she lives in far off land in Italy or in France. She can listen the wailing of the casuarina tree over the loss of her siblings. Each memory of her brother and sister blinds her eyes with hot tears. Do you think the nature can communicate with human beings? In this poem, Toru Dutt strongly believes that nature communicates with human beings. The poetess says that she can communicate with the casuarina tree. She herself heard the strange music of the tree from faraway countries. Let's move on to the final stanza, that is the fifth stanza. In the final stanza, the poetess is trying to consecrate or make the casuarina tree holy by writing a poem or a verse. She says that the casuarina tree is very much loved by her brother and sister and also by herself. To show her love towards the casuarina tree, she is going to write a poem. Through her poem, the casuarina tree will be immortalized. The casuarina tree will be given life. In the final stanza, Toru Dutt gives an allusion or reference with Wordsworth's poem Yew Trees of the Borrowdale. Do you know Wordsworth? William Wordsworth? William Wordsworth is one of the most famous romantic poets. Through his poem Yew Trees of Borrowdale, he tried to immortalize the yew trees in Borrowdale. Likewise, our poetess Toru Dutt also trying to immortalize the casuarina tree. Toru Dutt is trying to give life to the casuarina tree through her poem. Toru Dutt says that there may be limitations for her as a poet. Her poem may be weak, but her passionate love for the tree will protect it from being forgotten. Her love towards the casuarina tree will be expressed through her poem. Because of that, the casuarina tree will be remembered by the future generation. Here ends the poem Our Casuarina Tree. I hope you enjoyed the poem. Thank you.